And we've got the other headset here, the Cisco Headset 730. Right from the start, it's a very different proposition, okay? And if you have a look, the first thing you notice is the set of instructions now are not, you must read this, it's a set of visual instructions, what people are doing nowadays. Little things like telling you that that is the right-hand side as you open it up. There is a right way and a wrong way to put them on, and a set of instructions based upon what buttons are on the device. Also, apps that are available to control the headset. Okay, I'm not one for instructions, no matter how simple they are. Let's see if this is intuitive enough to make it work. Right from the start, as you can see, the device is clearly much more of a lifestyle device, and you can see it's designed to be taken out of the office.
Yeah,
for use. Whereas the other one, with the holder and so on, looks like it belongs in the office all the time. It's much more of a work device, whereas this one, right from the start, does look a little bit more like a lifestyle device as well. Now, let's open it up, and there you go. We did open it before, but it's still nice. I understand it comes in a black as well as this very cool grey. And let's have a play and let's have a look at what's in this device and see what we notice immediately. First thing I notice is the fact that you've got grills here, which do indicate which way it needs to go forward. That's why I gather the microphones are sitting behind.
Yep.
We also see that there is a mute button there, which is pretty good. Okay. And on this side, I don't think I'm going to use that mute button all that often, actually. Just thinking about it. Now, on this side, you can see here we've got an off NC for noise cancelling and A and B for ambient. So I think ambient, to my understanding of it, allows more external noise to come in. So if you're riding around or walking around, you want to be aware of traffic noise, that's the way to do it. Also on here, if we look further down, we've got a 3.5mm mini jack to allow you to plug this into a device that requires, a headphone cable. You'll need to supply that. And a USB-C, which will be for charging. But also, if you've got the ability to connect your device via USB-C, and look, somewhere along the line, if there are firmware updates, it's probably going to happen via that as well. On the sides here, volume buttons, forward and back buttons, and forward and back is if you're using this for listening to your songs. And on this side, this is, as we saw in the instructions, this is the answer or hang up button. I think we should just give it a try, don't you? First thing I'm going to do is I should turn it on.
Yep.
And on the handset itself, we should probably get the Bluetooth functions up. Okay. So you're going in settings. There's Bluetooth, the select button. Bluetooth is on. Bluetooth mode phone, which I think is going to be sensible in
this
case.
You can leave it at that. The default's okay.
All right. And then devices, set devices. Now, if we're going to do scan, I need to get the Bluetooth function working, and I flick that switch upwards for 2 seconds until the blue light starts to flash, and now it's in pairing mode. You've hit the scan button. It's saying that it's scanning for Bluetooth devices. And there it is, Cisco headset 730, number 176. Hit the connect button. I'm going to listen in, see if I can hear it.
It's connected?
Yeah, it is connected. It told me so as well. In theory, we're done. Is that right?
We are done. Ready
to
go.
Well, that was easy. That was ridiculously easy. Do you want to give me a call?
I can do that.
Oh, it's telling me. Listen. All right, it's telling me it's got an incoming call. I better answer it. I've hit the button. Hello, Chris, how are you? And there you go, I'm connected. It's fantastic, look at that. So easy, as you'd expect.